Our next guest, perfect guest to talk to out of this. He worked at Google X from 2016 to 2022 in the Moonshot division and then brought his company out of Google. That would be SandboxAQ. He's also the author of Quantum Computing and Applied Approach. Jack Hidary is here.
Sarah, great to be here.
Welcome at our CEO.
What a setting.
Yeah, I mean, it's gorgeous. So having worked at Google, some of the questions that Deirdre raised about where Alphabet is in terms of leadership on Gemini and its AI model. What do you think?
Well, first of all, this week, big topic is going to be coding. And so in Star Wars, they talk about the cloning wars have begun. Well, the coding wars have begun now.
What does that mean?
And what does that mean? It means that we expect a big announcement today, tomorrow, at the I.O. Summit on Evolve, Alpha Evolve. That's going to be Google's entrant into the AI that helps you code, helps programmers get the code out. OpenAI just dropped its one called Codex. There's Cursor out there. There's Windsurf. This is a major battle right now because there's only about 6 to 12 months left before developers will lock in to their choice of AI to help them code. And coding is a key killer app for AI. So that's one big topic that we'll see.
Who has leadership on that now?
Right now, it's literally a jump ball. It's literally a jump ball. So that's going to be the big fight of the next 6, 12 months. That's on the prosumer side. When we look at the B2B side, that is still far from over as a fight. So Gemini really needs to step up in terms of its integration with Workspace, Google Slides, Google Docs, Google Sheets. All that is yet to come. Hopefully, they'll make some announcements this week on that. Microsoft and ChatGPT already have a tight relationship. We'll see how that evolves in the negotiation between Satya and Sam. But right now, we'll see how ChatGPT is more integrated into Word and Doc than Gemini has been in Workspace. So look out for those announcements as well.
Deirdre was just mentioning the lower valuation than some of the other big mega cap names. Do you buy the idea that some of their search is getting eaten into by, I mean, I'm using Grok every single day. People are using ChatGPT. How existential is that for Google?
Well, look, there's really three battles of AI. There's consumer, which is like search and basically personal apps. There's prosumer, which is coding, writing emails, stuff like that. And then there's the B2B. On the consumer side, you're definitely going to see a dispersion of usage right now where Google Gemini is now integrated into Google Search. So I think it's still because of the publisher ecosystem that it has. When you go to most websites, most of those ads are served by Google. So it's not just Google.com that is really at stake. It's really the whole publishing ecosystem that Google really is the leader on. So I think Google still has a strong position, although it will be dispersed. The big question is not so much the consumer side. It's really prosumer, like coders, and then B2B is where the big money is going to be.
Enterprise,
that is
yeah.
just beginning now.
And you're in that world, too. I mean,
That's
we should
right.
mention Eric Schmidt, of course. Google is the chairman.
Chairman of SandboxAQ.
SandboxAQ. AQ is AI. Q is quantitative.
That's right. Quantum.
Quantum. So you're sort of on the cusp of both of these big trends. How is yours different than a large language model, and what are you seeing from your enterprise customers?
Right. So exactly. So most of the conversation around AI right now has been large language models trained on social media, trained on cat pictures, all good stuff, particularly for the consumer side. But when it comes to big business, when it comes to making a new medicine, when it comes to making a new therapeutic for cancer, for Alzheimer's, new energy that we need to power the data centers that we all talk about on this show and elsewhere, that needs a quantitative AI, AI that's trained on physics and engineering and chemistry and biology and toxicology. That AI is very different. That's a large quantitative model, LQM, versus LM. And I'm proud to say SandboxAQ is the pace setter right now globally in LQMs.
But there's also a lot of quantum news. I mean, do we watch for that from Google, for instance? And where is Google
relative to
some of the competitors?
Yeah, what's exciting, Sarah, is that we're seeing the quantum story really start to take hold. Quantum computing companies, there are a number, about 30 companies out there that are building physical quantum computers. Amazon's building one, Microsoft, Google.
IBM.
IBM has a great one as well. Then there's a lot of startups. D-Wave is in the news today.
Yeah, in the news today. D-Wave announces general availability of Advantage 2 quantum computer, most advanced performance
system. So there's a handful of public stocks right now.
Yeah.
D-Wave is public. IonQ is public. Rigetti is public. So we're seeing a lot of movement in those stocks as well. My recommendation to folks is not to focus on one of those stocks, but probably a basket right now, because all those quantum stocks probably ripe for M&A over the next 36 months. I'm expecting some of those public quantum stocks to be bought by some of the hyperscalers over the next 36, 48 months.
Why? What are they going to do with them, and when do we see the applications?
No, fundamental question. Right now, the hyperscalers are in the key cloud wars where they're really fighting in terms of market share for their clouds, GCP, AWS, Azure. quantum adds value to their clouds. And so they're doing stuff natively. They're offering new quantum computers natively, but they're going to want to offer a bigger range of quantum computers. And that means acquisition. That means M&A. So I'm expecting in the next 36, 48 months, we're going to see a kickoff of a M&A frenzy in the quantum side.
We're also sort of more aware, increasingly aware of the global race for all of this, AI and quantum. Last week in Saudi Arabia, it was very apparent that they want to become a global hub and that the U.S. wants it to build on the tech stack. What do we have to know about how the lines are getting drawn geographically and geopolitically around all this?
Yeah, this is a critical moment right now geopolitically for AI. What's the jump ball right now are the Gulf states between the competitiveness of U.S. and China, the People's Republic of China and the U.S. There is a major AI race going on right now. And the Gulf states, Saudi Arabia, Qatar, Bahrain, UAE, mm-hmm. these are the key places that will determine which way they will go. Will they side with the U.S.? Will they side to China? So far, the U.S. has been successful drawing them to our side. But it means continued engagement to make sure that they're engaging with us in a key ecosystem. The fundamental announcements made last week, particularly with chips now being sold to UAE,
NVIDIA,
to other
AMD.
Countries. Jensen was there ground. And again, Jensen's one of our partners, NVIDIA, one of our partners as well. It's critical to see that kind of exchange of technology with the Gulf states.
Why? We're what very does it mean supportive for China? And what is your latest read on China's capabilities at this point?
China is putting it all on the table. I mean, they're pushing all the chips on because they know how critical AI and quantum are. Quantum's important. You know, right now, BlackRock just issued an announcement just the last few days of the threat to Bitcoin. Bitcoin started moving in the last 48 hours because of BlackRock's disclosure that quantum one day will undermine the cryptography of Bitcoin itself. So that's something for investors to watch there.
Quantum will undermine Bitcoin?
That's right, because the current structure of Bitcoin is structured on cryptography. The crypto and cryptocurrency is cryptography. And BlackRock just announced the last 48 hours in a disclosure that quantum is a key threat to the current way. Now, what Bitcoin has to do is, as a community, is change out that cryptography for quantum-safe cryptography. So that's what's happening with China there. And then on AI, China is all in. You've seen DeepSeek. You've seen Alibaba's Qianwen.
People are using it here.
It's worldwide. And so it's critical that the Gulf states, that U.S. engage the Gulf states. That is a critical piece on the chessboard right now to make sure that they go with us and not with China. And that's why this trip was so important at this moment.
Well, we're lucky to have you to break all this complicated stuff down for us. Thank you, Jack. Always good to talk
to you.
Love the hat. Jack Hidary, Sandbox AQ.